Now we're going to show you three sets of data. First, investment. From 2010 to 2018, net equity capital investment flows have been practically zero from Russia. There were net outflows in 2011, 2015, and 2018, and inflows of less than $20,000 in 2012, 2013, and 2016. The good news here, there's nowhere to go but up for Russian investment in the Philippines. Now, cash remittances from Russia are better compared to Russian investment inflows, but not by much. They were on an uptrend up to 2015, but they have been slumping since then, falling to $26 million in 2018. That is a drop in the ocean when compared to the overall total of $29 billion for that year, based on data from the Philippine Central Bank. Now, trade data with Russia is also unremarkable. Imports are shown in blue and measured in hundreds of millions of dollars. Exports are shown in orange, and they are measured in tens of millions. That immediately tells you Russia enjoys a big trade surplus with the Philippines. In other words, they are benefiting more from this relationship. Exports to Russia by the Philippines include fruits such as mangoes, bananas, and pineapples, coconut oil, packaging, fibers, garments, and various electronics. Imports from Russia include crude oil, various chemicals, sausage and ham casings, and metal ores. Both imports and exports have been on an uptrend since President Duterte started his term in 2016. But still, Russia is outside the Philippines' top 20 trade partners. But it was inside the top 20 in terms of imports in 2018 when Russia's shipments actually spiked 155% year on year. Total value of imports from Russia hit $1.3 billion, good for 19th in the top 20 that year. For Dissecting Data, I'm Warren De Guzman. We'll be right back.